Officer on scene. Looks like we have a situation here.
Thank you. Boyd.
Is everything okay, Jack? I'm not calling in the middle of a job.
No, you're okay. Did you find her?
Yes, I found her. Nothing shocking, don't worry. She's living with an insurance agent in the suburbs. He's 31 years old, recently divorced. He has a funny car, you know, like in that movie where that...
Did you talk to her?
Yeah, we talked. More like I talked, and she basically cried. God, she hasn't cried so much since high school. You know, she was dating this boy from a restaurant, and what was his name? And
so, then Laura, she'll be back?
Of course she'll be back. She just needs time.
Time? You mean once she gets tired of screwing the insurance agent?
Jack, you're talking about my daughter.
Yeah, I know. I just want her to come back as soon as possible.
Don't worry, I'm with you. We just need a little patience. I know it's asking a lot, Jack, but you really just gotta be patient. Wait for my call.
All right. Again, I'll wait for the call. Yes, understood. I know the situation is asking a lot from you too, Mrs. Markham. Thank you. And please, call me anytime.
Jack?
Yeah?
You okay for money?
Excuse me?
Well, you know, where the papers were talking about your resignation, they said you and Laura were a little tight, and I thought maybe you'd...
Good God.
Jack? Jack?
1010A.
Thank you.
afraid, don't carry no gap this train. This train don't carry no gamblers. This train don't carry no gamblers, no crap shooters or midnight ramblers. This train don't carry no gamblers. This train. While I was on that train at 5:02, heading for Mobile, I had a couple of dicks in my pocket just to make the price of a meal. Well, I threw them on the blanket and they started doing tricks. I was on that train at 5:02. They threw me off at 5:06. Well, this train don't carry no gamblers.
This train, this train.
This train don't carry no gamblers.
This train.
This train.